sir. I want some more.
What?
Please, sir. I want some more.
More?
Catch him!
Snatch him!
Hold him!
Scold him!
Pound him! Trounce him! Pick him up and bounce him! Yeah!
Before we put the lad to task, may I be so curious as to ask his name?
Oliver! Oliver!
Never before has a boy asked for more.
Oliver! Oliver!
Won't ask for more when he knows what's in store.
There's a dark, thin, winding stairway without any banister, which will throw him down and feed him on cockroaches served in a canister.
Oliver! Oliver!
What will he do when he's turned black and blue?
He will curse the day somebody named him Oliver! Oliver! Oliver!
Never before has a boy asked for more.
Oliver!
There's a sooty chimney long overdue for a sweeping out, which will push him up, and one day next year with the rats he'll come creeping out.
Oliver! Oliver!
What will he do in this terrible stew?
He will ruin the day somebody named him Oliver!
Oliver! Oliver! Never before has a boy asked for more. Oliver! Oliver!
Raise and decorum restore, I implore!
Let us face this case, it's unprecedented, quite utterly.
He's disgraced this place.
And encourage the others to wallow in gluttony.
Oliver! Oliver!
Lock him in jail and then put him on sale for
the highest bid. Glad to be rid of Oliver!
Collect his belongings and bring him back to me when you've done. To bed! All of you!
Mrs. Corney, that boy was born to be hung. I've never been so shocked in all my days.
Hush, Mr. B, you've had quite a turn, and I fancy you might enjoy a little drop of something special.
What is it?
Well, it's what I'm obliged to keep a little of in the house, to put into the blessed infant's medicine when they ain't well. And I'll not deceive you, Mr. B. It's gin.
Oh. You are a humane woman, Mrs. Corney. It's nice to be appreciated, Mrs. Corney. Them paupers don't appreciate me. Anti-parochial they are, Mrs. Corney. Anti-parochial. We have given away, as a matter of fact, a cheese and a half and 10 loaves this very afternoon. And still, them paupers ain't contented.
Of course they're not. When would they be? Sweet, Mr. Bumble?
Oh, sweet indeed, Mom. Very sweet.
Bless you.
Do you still keep a cat, Mom?
Oh, yes, and kittens, too. I'm so fond of them, you can't imagine, Mr. Bumble. They are so happy, so cheerful, so frolicsome that they are quite companions for me.
Very domestic animals indeed, Mum.
And so very fond of their home, too, that it's really quite a pleasure, I'm sure.
Mr. Corney, I must say this. Any cat or kitten that could live with you, Mum, and not be fond of its home is an idiot, Mum, and don't deserve to live in it.
Oh, Mr. Bumble.
No disguising facts, Mum. An idiot. I would drown it myself. With pleasure.
Then you are a very cruel man and an hard-hearted man besides.
Hard? Hard-hearted, Mrs. Corney? Are you hard-hearted, Mrs. Corney?
Oh, my. What a very curious question coming from a single man. What can you want to know for, Mr. Bumble? Mr. Bumble! I shall scream!
No, you wouldn't. Hey, oh, if I wanted something special, then you wouldn't say no. Did I nearly catch you smiling? Yes, I did, and it's beguiling. If your hand were close, I'd press it. Yes, you like it, come confess it. Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
I shall scream. I shall scream till they hasten to my rescue. I shall scream.
Since there's nobody that's near us who could see us or could hear us, if I asked you, can I kiss you? Say, what will my pretty miss do?
I shall scream, scream, scream.
If I pinch you one pinch from your shy protective shell, could I uninch you one inch? Will my blithesome buxom beauty let a suitor do his duty? Though his lap ain't very large, dear, sit upon it, there's no charge, dear. Will you sit?
No, I shan't.
Will you sit?
I shall scream. I shall scream for the safety of my virtue. I shall scream. Though your knee is rather cozy, see my cheeks are getting rosy. You would have me in your power if I sat here for an hour.
I shall scream, scream, scream.
You're a naughty bad man. If you think I can't be proper, prim and haughty, I can. And your pardon if I mention, you must state your true intention.
Is there not another room here?
No.
If there were a bride and groom here, would there be?
Well, there might.
Then we shall see.
I shall scream. I shall scream at the thought of what you're thinking. I shall scream.
You will wonder where your scream went when we come to an agreement. As my lovey-dovey's chubby, would she love a chubby hubby?
I shall scream, Mr. Bumble. I shall scream, Bumble Wumble. I shall scream, scream!
Scream!
I'd best be off. See what I can get for this young scallywag.
Be sure you get a good price for him, Mr. Bumble.
Hold this one second for me. Fucking pants did it again. Okay, okay, that's it.
One boy. Boy for sale, he's going cheap, only 7 guineas, that or thereabout. Small boy, rather pale, from lack of sleep, feed him gruel dinners, stop him getting stout. If I should say he wasn't very greedy, I could not, I'd be telling you a tale. One boy, boy for sale, come take a peep. Have you ever seen as nice a boy for sale?
liberal terms, Mr. Sour, very liberal terms. £3.
Well, as a matter of fact, I was needing a boy.
It's settled then. One broke your apprentice. £3, please.
If you don't mind, cash upon liking, Mr. Bumble. Cash upon liking. Mrs. Sourberry?
What is it?
Oliver, hold your head up, sir.
Well, what do you want? What is it? Oh, Mr. Bumble.
My dear, I was telling Mr. Bumble that we might consider taking in this boy to help in the shop.
Dear me, he's rather small.
Oh, he is small, Mum. There's no denying it. But he'll grow. He'll grow.
Oh, I dare say he will. On our victuals and our drink. They're a waste of time, these workers' boys. They always cost more to keep than they're worth. Still, you men always think you know best.
But there's an expression of melancholy on his face, my dear, which is really very interesting. I think he would make a delightful coffin follower. I don't mean a regular coffin follower to attend the grown-ups, but only for the children's practice. It would be very novel to have a follower in proportion, my sweet.
Yes, it's a possibility. Very well then, boy, what's your name?
Oliver Twistman.
A singular name.
Aye, Mum, and one of me own choosing.
Yours, Mr. Bumble?
Mine, Mrs. Sourberry. We name our foundlings in alphabetical order. The last one was an S, Schwabble, on Endon. This one was a T, Twist, on Endon.
An orphan then, Mr. Bumble?
An orphan indeed, Mum. His mother gave birth to him, take one look at the boy, promptly dies without leaving so much as a name or forwarding address.
Very well then, Oliver Twist. You think you can look like that gentleman up there?
Maybe. Perhaps find a tall hat.
Never mind about tall hats.
Oh, yes, the boy's quite right. These things must be done proper and correct. Get the boy a hat. Stand underneath the picture, boy.
Delightful.
It's very becoming, Mum.
Yes. Yes. For once, I think you might have had a decent idea, Henry. Can you hold that expression, boy, for a long time with a crowd of people watching you?
Perhaps, ma'am.
He's a born undertaker's mute. I can see him in his black silk suit. Follow him behind the funeral procession with his features fixed in a suitable expression. There'll be horses with tall black plumes to escort us to the family tombs, with mourners in all corners who've been taught to weep in tune. Then the coffin lined with satin, that's your funeral.
That's your funeral.
Large enough to wear your hat in, that's your funeral.
That's your funeral.
We're just here to glamorize you for that endless sleep. You might just as well look fetching when you're 6 feet deep.
At the wake, we'll drink a toddy to the body beautiful.
That's your funeral.
Not our funeral.
That's your funeral. If you're fond of overeating, that's your funeral.
That's your funeral.
Starve yourself by undereating, that's your funeral.
That's your funeral. Visualize the earth descending on you, clod by clod. In the end, we'll lie underneath the sword. We will not reduce your prices,
keep your vices usual. That's your funeral.
Not our funeral.
That's your funeral.
I don't think this song is funny.
That's your funeral.
That's your funeral.
There's the boy, now where's my money?
That's your funeral.
That's your funeral.
We don't harbor thoughts macabre. There's no need to frown. In the end, we'll either burn you up or nail you down. We love coughs and wheezes and diseases called incurable. That's your funeral.
No one else's funeral.
That's your...
That's your... funeral. Very well then, boy. That's your job. Junior coffin follower. Have you eaten?
No, ma'am, not...
Charlotte! Charlotte! What? Bring in some of them bits we put out for the dog. It's been out all day, you won't miss them. I dare say the boy's not too dainty to eat them, are you, boy? Charlotte, that's the new boy. Well, give them to him. Charlotte, don't just stand there. Close the shutters. Henry, get to bed.
Splendid idea. The more I think about it, a follower in proportion.
Have you done?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. The dogs are to have it next. Very well then, Oliver Twist. There's your bed behind the coffin. I suppose you don't mind sleeping among the coffins? Doesn't matter whether you do or you don't. You can't sleep nowhere else.
Open the door, will you? Charlotte, open the door.
I will directly, sir.
Are you the new boy?
Yes, sir.
How old are you?
11, sir.
Then I'll whop you one when I get in there. You just see if I don't, you little workhouse brat.
Did you knock, sir?
I kicked.
Did you order a coffin, sir?
No, but you'll be wanting one before very long if you start cheeking your superiors.
You don't know who I am, I suppose, workout.
No, sir, I can't say I do.
I'm Mr. Noah Claypool, and you're under me. So open the shutters, you idle young scallywag.
Noah, I saved a nice little bit of bacon for your master from your master's breakfast. Oliver, pull up a chair for Mr. Noah and take the bits and go into the corner and eat them. And make haste, because I want you to mind the shop, do you hear?
Do you hear? Workhouse!
Here's your bacon, Noah.
Nice and greasy. Just how I like it. Whoa. What are you looking at, workhouse?
Law, Noah, let the boy alone.
Let him alone? I'm giving the boy a change, you silly thing. Everyone's left him alone. His mother's left him alone. His father's left him alone. They've all left him alone except dear, kind old Noah.
I better go downstairs. Something's burning.
Workhouse, how's your mother?
You leave my mother out of it. She's dead.
What did she die of? Shortage of breath?
No, she's just dead. She died of a broken heart.
Well, told to roll all right for Larry, workhouse. What's that you sniffling now?
You better not say anything more, C.
You better not say anything more, C. The cheek of it. The workhouse cheek of it. You know, workhouse, you couldn't help it then, and of course, you can't help it now. And I'm sure we're all very sorry for you, and pity you very much. But you must know, workhouse, your mother was a right down bad one.
What did you say?
And it's a good thing she died when she did, or she'd have been shipped off to Australia,
or hung from the gibbet as like as not.
Charlotte! Missus, is there a new voice murdering of me? Charlotte!
Oh, grateful virus, little Charlotte! Quick, get him in here! Quick, get the lid! Oh, Noah, Noah, run and get help! Oh, Charlotte, water, quick!
Oh, my God, she's going up!
Oh, Charlotte, we might have all been murdered in our beds! Oh, water, quick! Oh, you stupid girl! I wanted a drink! Oh, Charlotte, what's to become of us?
I found the beetle!
Oh, Mr. Bumble!
Oh, Mr. Bumble!
Where is he? Where is that audacious young savage?
He's in here.
Oliver, you in there?
You let me out.
Oliver, do you recognize this here voice, Oliver?
Yes, I do.
And you ain't afraid of it, Oliver? You ain't trembling whilst I speak, Oliver?
No, I'm not.
That boy must be mad. No one in his right mind would venture to speak to you like that.
It's not madness, Mum. It's meat.
What?
Meat, Mum. You've overfed the boy. You've raised an artificial soul and spirit in that boy, unbecoming of his station in life.
Oh, dear me. It's what becomes of being overgenerous.
If you would have just stuck to gruel, this would have never happened.
Oh, Henry! Oh, that boy, Oliver! You've no idea what's happened. We've had to lock him up!
Help!
Who said that? What's going on here? This coffin is not supposed to be occupied until tomorrow. It's reserved for a very important client.
You've been drinking.
Oliver, explain yourself!
He called my mother names.
Oh, so what we did, you ungrateful little wretch. She probably deserved that and worse.
She didn't.
She did.
It's a lie. Oh, 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 oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. Yeah.
He's gone.
Who's gone?
Oliver, he's run off.
Three pairs of mine run off after him.
it in a strand. Read all about it in a strand.
Huh?
What you staring at? Ain't you never seen a dwarf?
No, never I.
That's all right. Hungry?
Starving.
Here, catch. Tired?
Yes, I've been walking for 7 days.
7 days? Running away from the beak, you must be.
The what?
Now don't say you're not what a beak is, my flash mate.
A beak's a bird's mouth.
My eyes are green. A beak is a magistrate for your information. Who you run away from then? You're a man?
No, I'm an orphan. I've come to London to seek my fortune.
Oh, you have you?
Yes.
Got any lodgings?
No.
Money?
Not a farthing. Do you live in London?
When I'm at home, I suppose you need a place to sleep tonight, don't you? Are you accommodated?
No, I don't think so.
Then accommodated you shall be, my young mate. I know a certain place in a respectable gentleman who will give you lodgings for nothing and never ask for the change. That is, if any of the gentlemen he knows introduces you. And does he know me? Well, I should say he does. Not half we don't, and some.
Who's a respectable gentleman, then? Is he a charity gentleman?
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that. Not exactly. But if I introduces you, it's all right, on account of I happen to be a particular favourite of Mr. Fagin. That's his name, Mr. Fagin. By the way, if I'm introducing you to Fagin, I better get to know who you are, me old China.
My name's Oliver. Oliver Twist.
And I'm Jack Dawkins, better known among my intimate friends as the Artful Dodger.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Dawkins.
Come to think of it, I've got no intimate friends. See, what's the difference? You're coming with me.
Are you sure Mr. Fagin won't mind?
Mind? Consider yourself at home. Consider yourself one of the family. I've taken to you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There isn't a lot to spare. Who cares whatever we got, we share. If it's a chance to be, we should see some other days. Empty all the days, why gross? Always a chance to make somebody to foot the bill. Then the drinks are on the eggs. Consider yourself my mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can say, consider yourself one of us. Consider yourself
at home.
Consider yourself
one of the family.
We've taken you
so strong.
We're going to get along.
Consider yourself
well in.
Consider yourself.
There isn't a lot to spare.
Who cares what ever we got to share? Nobody tries to be la-di-da with what for tea. There's a cup of tea for all. Only his wife to be handy with the rolling pin. When the landlord comes to call, consider yourself our mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can stay.
Consider yourself.
Yes, one of us.
Consider yourself at home. So strong.
always a chance of being somebody to foot the bill. And the drinks are on the house. Come see yourself, run late. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can stay. Come see yourself, one of us.
Don't see yourself.
Well, in there isn't a lot to spare. Nobody's trying to clean the lollies all around the tea. There's a cup of tea for all. Responsibly handy with a rolling pin. When the landlord comes to call, come see yourself, our mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can say, come see yourself, one of us.
That's all about how it's done.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Let's have a show now. Let's have a show. Oh, wow, yeah. That's very good, very good. Oh, what's the dancer? Oh, what's he got over there? Oh, what's this? This is really funny. Yeah. I saw a light on his feet for a big fella.
For after some consideration, we can say, consider yourself one of us. Chance to be, we should see some harder days, empty lot of days, why grouse? Always a chance to meet somebody to foot the bill, and the drinks are on the ass.
Are on the
drinks are on the ass. Come see yourself, have fun. Come see yourself, part of the family. We've taken to you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There isn't a lot to spare. Who cares what every lot we share? It's a chance to be. We should see some harder days. Empty harder days. Why rouse? Always a chance to meet somebody to foot the bill. And the drinks are on the house. Come see yourself, our mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can stay. Come see yourself, one of us.
One of the family, we've taken to you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There isn't a lot to spare. Who cares what ever we got we share?
Thank you.
If it's your chance to be, we should see some otter days. Empty lot of days, why grouse? Always a chance we'll meet somebody to foot the bill. Then the drinks are on the out.
Come in, sir.
Cold city yourself.
Wait, we don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can say, come see yourself. One of us.
Bargain. Bargain. Bargain.
Why?
I've got a new friend to see you. Oliver Twist.
Sir?
Well, I hope I shall have the honour of your intimate acquaintance. But we are very happy to see you, Oliver. Very. Ain't we, boys?
Now, Apple, say we are.
Mr. Twist has come to London to seek his fortune.
Oh, so you've come to London to seek your fortune. Well, we'll see what we can do to help you with that. Yes, are you hungry?
Starving.
Charlie, take off the sausages. You like the sausages. Dodger, pull up a chair near the fire for Oliver.
Oh, Faggy, these sausages are mouldy.
Shut up and drink your gin. So, you're staring at the pocket handkerchiefs, eh, my dear? There are quite a few of them, ain't there? Well, we just hung them up there, ready for the walks. That's all, my dear.
Is this a laundry then, sir?
Well, not exactly, my dear. I suppose a laundry would be a very nice thing indeed, but our line of business pays a little better. Don't it, boys?
Yes, it does.
You see, Oliver, in this life, one thing counts. In the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two. Sing, boys.
Large amounts don't grow on trees. You have to pick a pocket or two.
Come on, boys, let's show Oliver how we do it.
Sit up here and watch how it's done, all right?
Why should we break our backs, stupidly paying tax? I better get some untaxed income. I better pick a pocket or two. You, I got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two.
Why should we all break our backs? Better pick a pocket or two.
Robin Hood, what a crook, gave away what he took. Charities, fine, subscribe to mine. Get out and pick a pocket or two. You, I got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two.
Robin Hood was far too good. He had to pick a pocket or two.
Take a tip from Bill Sykes, he can whip what he likes. I recall he started small, he had to pick a pocket or two. You, I got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you got to pick a pocket or two.
We could be like old Bill Sykes if we pick a pocket or two.
Hello, gent, passing by, something nice takes his eye. Everything's clear, attack the rear. Get out and pick a pocket or two. You've I got to pick a pocket or two. Boys,
they're nasty.
Well, they were clean last summer. You've got to pick a pocket or two.
Attack the rear, get in a bigger pocket or two.
When I I see someone rich, both my thumbs start to itch. If only to find some peace of mind, I have to pick a pocket or two. I got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, I got to pick a pocket or two.
Just to find some peace of mind, we have to pick a pocket or two. Just to find some peace.
All right, boys, put them all back in the box. All in the box. All of them. Come here. Good boy. What a crook. Well, boys, I hope you've all been hard at work today.
Hard and nails!
Good boys, good boys. So, Dodger, what have you got for me?
A couple of wallets.
Yeah? Well lined, I hope.
Only the best.
Not as heavy as they might be, but very nicely made. Very. Ingenious workman, ain't he, Oliver?
Did he make these himself?
With his own lily white hand.
All right, Charlie, that's enough. What have you got for me today?
Nose rags.
Oh, very good ones. Nose rags. Oh, yellow and green. But, Charlie, you haven't embroidered them too well, though, so we're going to have to pick out the initials with the needle. Oliver, you're going to have to learn how to do this too, my dear. And you're going to have to learn how to make wallets, like Dodgy and Charlie. You like that, wouldn't you, my dear?
Yes, sir, if you'll teach me.
Oh, certainly, certainly, my dear, no fee. Just do everything you see Dodgy and Charlie do. Make them your models, my dear. Especially Dodgy here, he's going to be a regular little Bill Sykes someday.
Who's Bill Sykes, Mr. Fagin?
Oh. Bill Sykes. Well, all in due time, my dear, all in due time. Now then, is my handkerchief protruding from my pocket?
Yes, sir.
Well then, why don't you see if you can take it out without my feeling it, like you saw the others do? You, I got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, is it gone?
Yes, sir, it's in my hand.
You've got to pick a pocket or two. I don't believe it. What a clever lad. I've never seen a sharper lad. Here's sixpence for you. I have to go to the bank. All right. Bedtime, all of you. It's our day's work ahead of you.
Where shall I sleep, sir?
Oh, Oliver, you can sleep right over there by the fire, by the warm. Right here, I'll get you a nightcap. Sorry, we're all out of cocoa. Have yourself a drop of gin. All right, settle down. Boys, I get to dodge you. Take your hat off in bed. Show some manners. Yeah. You know, Oliver, you are already quite a little gentleman. I mean, you've got a home, a profession, and sixpence on credit. If you go on like this, you shall be the greatest man of all time. All right, bedtime. Nighty-night. Da, 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 da. Got to pick a pocket or... Bill? Bill? At this hour? It's a bit late, ain't it? I mean, after all, people are trying to sleep around here. Where's the common decency? I'm going to have to give him a piece of me mind, I will. Well, Bill, what a pleasure to see you. What can I do for you? How are you getting on? very nice pair. Very, very. Too bad we don't have a pair to go with this. This is what... Oh. Oh, so you do have a pair. Well, very nice. Lovely, Bill, lovely. Very nice, very. Oh, well. Oh, and a solid silver fork. Too bad we don't have a spoon and a knife. Oh, we do. Oh, very nice, very. Oh, Bill, beautiful, beautiful. Oh, not so beautiful. Oh, and a ring. Lovely, Bill, lovely. This is all so sudden, Bill. I'll see what I can get for it. Oh, and pearls. Very nice, Bill. And you washed them. Oh, lovely, yes.
Oh, Fagin. Hand it over.
Bill. Cash? Me? Bill? You know I don't keep cash around here with all these thieves running about. I wouldn't dare.
Fagin.
Tomorrow, Bill. I've got to price it all out, proper and correct. Tomorrow. Usual place. 3 quibbles. I promise. That's a promise, Bill.
It better be.
I'm a real miser, you know. But can I help it? It's my little pleasure. A cup of coffee. And a quick count up. I mean, after all, who's going to look after me in my old age? Will you, Bertie? Will you? Ooh, very nice. What do you think of that? What are you doing awake? Quick, speak. What have you seen? Were you awake 5 minutes ago?
No.
10 minutes ago?
Not that I know of.
Be sure, be sure.
I'm sure.
All right, then. If you're sure, then I'm sure. Of course, I knew that all along, my dear. I only meant to frighten you. Did you see any of the pretty things, my dear?
Yes, sir.
They're mine, Oliver. My little property. All I have to live on in my old age. It's a terrible thing, Oliver. Old age.
May I get up now, sir?
Oh, well, certainly, my dear, certainly. There's a basin of water right over there. Go ahead and take a wash.
I washed yesterday.
Well, today's your birthday. Wash! The ladies are here, boys. Get up. The ladies are here. Ladies. Nancy in bed.
Ladies,
wake up.
Wake up. We'll have this or that if you don't mind. Where's the gin, Fagin?
Oh, all in moderation, my dear. All in moderation. Too much gin can be a dangerous thing for a pure young girl.
And what's wrong with a bit of danger then, Mr. Fagin? After all, it's the only bit of excitement we've got. And who would deny us that small pleasure? Small pleasures, who would deny us these?
Not me!
Gin toddies, large measures, no skimping if you please. I rough it, I love it, life is a game of chance. I'll never tire of it, leading this merry dance. If you don't mind having to go without things, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
Though it ain't all jolly old pleasure outings, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
When you've got someone to love, you forget your cares and strife. Let the
prudes look down at us, let the wide world frown at us. It's a fine,
fine life.
Ain't that right, Ben?
Yeah, that's right, Nancy. Who cares if straight laces sneer at us in the street? Fine airs and fine graces
don't have to sing to meet.
We wander through London, who knows what we may find? There's pockets left undone on many a behind.
If you don't mind taking it as it turns out, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
Keep the candle burning until it burns out. It's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
Though you sometimes do come by the occasional black eye, you can always cover one till he blacks the other one, but you don't dare cry.
No flounces, no feathers, no frills or furbelows. All winds and all weathers ain't good for fancy clothes.
These trappings,
these tatters,
these we can just afford. What future?
What matters?
We've got our bed and board.
If you don't mind having a deal with failure, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
No disease rats threaten to bring the plague in. It's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
Though the grass is green and dense on the right side of the fence, but we take good care of it and we get our share of it, and we don't
mean pets.
If you don't mind having to make a lump, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
Though there's no tea sucking and they can come this, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
Not for me, the happy home, happy husband, happy wife. Though it sometimes touches me for the likes of such as me. Mine's a fine,
fine life.
Yeah, who's this then, Fagin?
Oh, ladies, I forgot to introduce you to our new lodger, Mr. Oliver Twist, Esquire, Nancy and Bet.
Charmed.
Pleased to meet you, I'm sure.
Oh, yes, we're all quality here. We're all ladies and gentlemen.
Don't you take no notice of them, Oliver, just because you got manners, and they ain't
all of them.
You weren't no quality if you saw none of you. Dodger?
Yeah?
Have you seen the way them quality gentlemen treats the ladies?
Of course I have.
Shall we show them how it's done?
Definitely.
How's it go then, Dodger? It's all this bowing and that's offender.
Don't let your petticoat stay a little much, my darling.
And we'd all go lost.
We'd all go lost. Yes. Aunt Dean. Anything for you, dear. Anything for you mean everything to me. I know that I'd go anywhere for your smile. Anywhere for your smile. Everywhere I'd see.
Would you climb a hill?
Anything.
Wear a daffodil?
Anything.
Leave me all your will?
Anything.
Even fight my bill?
What fisticuffs? Risk everything for one kiss. Anything. Yes, I'd do anything.
Anything.
Anything. For you!
Yeah, Oliver, you do everything you saw Dodger do, and I'll help you with the words, all right? I'll do anything. Here we go.
I'd do anything for you, dear. Anything
for you mean?
For you mean everything to me.
It's
my shoe.
Anything.
Paint your face bright blue.
Anything.
Catch a kangaroo.
Anything.
Go to Timbuktu.
And back again, I'd risk everything for one kiss. Everything, yes, I do. Anything.
Anything.
Anything for you.
Would you rob a shop?
Anything.
Or would you risk a drop?
Anything.
And all your eyes go pop?
Anything.
Or when you come down plop?
Hey, everything. We'd risk life and limb to keep you in the swim. Yes, we do.
All right, lads, I can't have you lying about here all day. There's fine pickings on the street and hard work to be done, so get out there and earn your keep.
But, Fagin, we was all going to see the hanging.
You're going to be hanging soon enough yourself, so don't worry about it. Nancy, hadn't you better get back before Bill wakes up?
Yeah, you're right. Oliver, you be careful. Ta-ta, you lot!
Ta-ta!
But don't get on!
Dodger, come here, Oliver. Dodger, I want you to take Oliver with you today. Oliver, you got to make a start somewhere. And believe me, you couldn't make a finer start. Good luck on your first job, Oliver, my dear. I shall be waiting for you here when you get back.
Line up!
Line up!
Single file!
Single file!
Present!
You can go, but be back soon. You can go, but while you're working, there's plates and pacing round until you're home safe and sound. Very well, but be back soon. Who can tell where danger's lurking? Do not forget this tune. Be back soon.
How could we forget? How could we let Auntie old Fagin worry? We love him so we'll come back home in no such a great big hurry.
It's him that pays the piper.
It's us that pays his tune. So long, feather bell, pip, pip, cheerio. We'll be back soon.
You can go, but be back soon. You can go, but bring back plenty of pocket handkerchiefs. And you should be clever thieves. We'll be quick and be back soon. There's a sixpence here for 20. Do not forget this tune. Be back soon.
Our pockets are low, don't want to go. That time's up on the hour.
A wallet fat and an old man's hat.
The crowd draws from the tower. We know the bows we roll us,
but they don't know this tune. So long, farewell, flip, flip, cheerio. We'll be back soon.
Cheerio, we'll be back soon. I don't know, somehow I'll miss ya. I love ya, that's why I say cheerio, not goodbye. Don't be gone long, be back soon. Give me one long last look, bless you. Remember our old tune. Be back soon.
We must disappear, we'll be back today, perhaps tomorrow. We'll miss you too.
It's sad but true, parting is such sweet sorrow.
And when we're in the distance, you'll hear this whisper too. So long, farewell, pip, pip, cheerio, we'll be back soon.
We must disappear, we'll soon. Be back
soon. I don't know, somehow I'll miss you. I love you, that's why I say cheerio, not goodbye. Don't be gone, don't be back soon. Give me one more last look, bless you. Remember our road to
cheerio, we'll be back soon.
And when we're in the distance, you'll hear this whisper too. So long, pretty well, pip, pip, cheerio, we'll be back soon.
So long, pretty well, pip, pip, we'll be back soon. So long, pretty well, pip, pip,
Toby. Oliver,
Come on, give it back. Stop that boy!
Stop the cry out
here. My pocket's been picked! That's him. That's the boy.
Thank you.
Strong men tremble when they hear it. They've got cause enough to fear it. It's much blacker than they smear it. Nobody mentions my name. Rich men hold their £5 notes out. Saves me emptying their coats out. They know I could tear their throats out just to live up to my name. With me, Jimmy, in me hand, let me see the man who dares stop me. Take him what I may, he can start to say his prayers. Biceps like an iron girder, fit for doing of a murder. If I just so much as heard a bloke even whisper my name, Bill Sykes. Some tough slumming with his valley bumped into me in the alley. Now his eyes will never tally. He'd never heard of my name. One bloke used to boast the claim he could take my name in vain. Poor bloke, shame he was so green, never was he seen again. Once bad, what's the good of turning? In hell, I'll be there a-burning. Meanwhile, think of what I'm earning, all on account of my name. What is it? What is it? What is it?
Bill Sykes.
Where's the boy? Now then, what have become of Oliver?
I took away in a coach.
Who coach? What coach? Where coach?
Gordon had done the job, they took him to court. We waited outside, the old man would have come and saw with Oliver. I took away in my coach.
Where to? Quick, speak.
19, Central Gardens, Bloomsbury, I ran all the way.
Why didn't you look after him? Why did you bring him back with you? You would never have let him out of your sight.
Fagin looks worried.
One of us, Bill. A new boy went out today on his first job with Dodger, and I'm afraid he may say something that will get us into trouble.
That's very likely. You're blowed upon, Fagin.
And I'm afraid, you see, that if the game were up for us, it might be up for a good many more as well. And it might come out rather worse for you, my dear, than it would for me.
Why, you old...
Oh.
Somebody better find out what's been done or said. If he hasn't talked yet, there's still a chance we might get him back without suspicion. And we'll nab him the moment he dares to step out of that house. Now who's going to go?
I suppose it'll have to be me.
Oh, shut your trap, Dodger. You've already caused enough trouble. It's got to be done in the quiet, without any fuss. Now, who's got to go?
Why, Nancy, the very thing. What do you say?
It's no good trying it on me.
And just what do you mean by that remark?
What I say, Bill, I'm not going. Why can't you leave the boy alone? He won't do you no harm. Why can't you leave him where he is, where he'll get the chance at a decent life?
You'll bring him back here, my girl. Unless you want to feel my hands around your throat!
Nancy, if he talked, think what would happen to us. Think what would happen to Bill. It would be the gallows, Nancy, the gallows. You wouldn't let that happen to Bill, not to your Bill.
She'll go, Fagin.
No, she won't, Fagin.
Yes, she will!
All right, Bet. Go home.
Go home! That's a good girl.
As long as he needs me. Oh yeah, he does need me. In spite of what you see, I'm sure that he needs me. Who else would love him still, when they've been used so ill? He knows I always will, as long as he needs me. I miss him so much when he's gone, but when he's near me, I don't let on the way I feel inside, the love I have to hide, the hell I've got my pride. As long as he needs me, he doesn't say the things he should. He acts the way he thinks he should. But all the same, I'll play this game his way. As long where I must be, I'll cling on steadfastly as long as he needs me, as long as life is long. I'll love him right or wrong, and somehow I'll be strong as long as he needs me. If you are lonely, then you will know when someone needs you, you love them so. Try his trust, though people say I must. I've got to stay true and just as long as he needs.
my sweet red roses, two blooms for a penny. Who will buy my sweet red roses, two blooms for a penny? Who will buy my sweet red roses, two blooms for a penny?
Will you buy any milk today, mistress? Any milk today, mistress?
Come along, Dr. Grimmick. I think you'll find much improvement in the boy.
That, sir, is for me to decide.
Thank you, Mrs. Bedwin.
Mr. Brownlow.
How do you feel today, Oliver?
Very happy, sir. May I stay here always, sir?
If you wish, dear boy, if you wish. Here's the doctor come to see you.
Well, he certainly is looking better. But you're still not sleeping well, are you?
Yes, I sleep very well.
Ah, bad dreams, Herb, no doubt. Nightmares, eh?
No, sir, I don't have dreams.
Thought so. But you're hungry, aren't you?
No, Doctor.
No, not hungry. Not thirsty, are you? If that boy is thirsty, I shall eat my head. Are you?
Yes, sir, I'm rather thirsty.
Just as I expected. It's very natural he should be thirsty. Yeah. Maybe give him a little tea.
Thank you, Doctor. May I get up now, sir?
Say ah.
Ah.
I think you may. And take a little fresh air. Don't keep him too warm, Mrs. Bedwin. But be careful that you don't let him be too cold. Will you have the goodness?
Certainly, Doctor.
You'll be glad to be up again, Oliver.
Do I wear these?
Well, you certainly can't wear your old ones. They've gone to the furnace. Hurry now.
He's a fine-looking boy, don't you think, Grimmick?
Couldn't tell you. Only know two sorts of boys. Mealy boys and beef-faced boys.
And which is Oliver?
Mealy. Where does he come from?
You know, I haven't the faintest idea. He was arrested for stealing my pocket handkerchief, but when I found out what really happened from the shopkeeper and he was released by the magistrate, I brought him here to make what amends I could. Although I must confess, I find myself strangely attached to the child.
He's deceiving you, my good friend. He's had a fever. What of that? Fevers are not peculiar to good people, are they? Bad people have fevers sometimes, don't they? He stole your pocket handkerchief, didn't he? Then he'll steal more, sir. What do you know of him? Nothing.
Yeah, only that he's an orphan. And yet, it's strange. There's something in the boy's face. I can't explain it, but somewhere, I seem to have seen him before. Somewhere a long time ago.
Stuff and nonsense. You're imagining things.
Yes, what is it? Yes, what does he want? Books, oh yes. Thank you. And I've these for you to return. Hey, excuse me. Oh, really? Really, really? And I did so want to return these today.
Why not have Oliver take them?
Yes, please let me take the books.
Yes, well, yes, dear boy, if you wish, then you shall. Now, here's what I want you to do. Take these to Mr. Jessup. He's just down the road. When you get there, tell him you're there to pay the £4.10 that I owe. Here's a £5 note. Now, it shouldn't take you long. Don't rush. I'll expect you back in 10 minutes.
She's a very pretty lady, isn't she?
Yes, it's a portrait of my daughter, Agnes.
Well, I'll take the books then, sir.
Yes, you take the books.
Ha! You don't really expect him to come back now, do you? With a new suit of clothes on his back and a £5 note in his pocket. My dear Mr. Brownlow, if he does, I'll eat my head.
Dr. Grimmick, have a look at this portrait. Don't you think my daughter Agnes bears a remarkable resemblance to Oliver?
Can't say I do.
Well, Doctor, when he returns, in 10 minutes, I believe you shall.
Yes, Mr. Brownlow, in 10 minutes.
Who will buy?
Who will buy? Keep the skies so blue, there must be
worried out of our heads.
What's the matter, love?
Oh, he ran away 2 weeks ago from his parents, who are hard-working, respectable people, to join a set of thieves and bad characters.
It's a lie.
He almost broke his mum's heart.
It's a lie.
Wretch, go out, you little brim.
Oh, yes. Not. I have some of the oil, Father. I'm an orphan.
Oh, heavens, just listen to him.
Beth, tell them to let me go.
See, he knows his sister's name. He can't hide that. Make him come home or he'll kill us.
He's just playing on.
What the devil's all this? Young Oliver. Go on home to your poor mother, you young wretch. Go on home. And what's this? Books too? You've been stealing again. He's nothing but a thief and a vagabond.
That's right, that's what he needs.
Help, help, I don't belong to them.
All right, now, you little bleeder, you're coming with us.
Leave him alone, Bill.
Say goodbye to your fancy living.
Leave him alone, Bill. We're here now.
Oliver, my dear, you've come home again.
Fagin, look at his dogs.
He's got books.
Delighted to see you looking so well, my dear. The artful dodgers will give you a new suit of clothes for fear you might spoil those nice Sunday ones. Why didn't you write and tell us you were coming? We would have prepared a nice warm supper for you.
Oh! Look at this!
What's this? What? That's mine, Fagin.
No, Bill, mine.
If that ain't mine, mine and Nancy's, that is, I'll take the boy back again.
No, mine, Bill, mine. Here, you can have the books.
Fair or not, hand it over, you avaricious old skeleton. As for our share of the trouble, and not half enough, neither.
This is hardly fair, Bill.
You
is
can keep the books. Start a library.
You can't take the books or the money. They belong to Mr. Brownlow. And if he finds out you'll have them, he'll be down here after you.
Oh, he'll be down here, will he?
Leave him alone, Bill.
What have you told him about us?
Nothing.
Fagin! Fagin! I'll wait till this little scoundrel's told him everything.
Help!
Oh! Try and run away, will you?
Leave him alone, Bill!
Stand off of me or I'll split your head open!
Go on, then. Kill me. You laughed at you before I let you lay a hand on that boy.
Keep out of this. I'm warning you.
All right. We've got him. What's the matter?
The girl's gone mad, Fagin.
No, she hasn't, Fagin. Don't think it.
Oh, well, then keep quiet, will you? All this violence.
Tell them all about us, will you?
I won't stand by and see it done, Bill.
Why, Nancy, you're wonderful today. Such talent. What an actress.
Am I? Well, take care I don't overdo it. Because if I do, I'm going to put my mark on some of you, and I don't care if I am for it.
You? Do you know who you are and what you are?
Yeah, I know all about that. You don't have to tell me.
Yeah, find one you are for a boy to make a friend of.
Oh, Lord help me, I am. And I wish I'd have been struck down dead before lending a hand and bringing him back here. After tonight, he's a liar and a thief and all that's bad. Ain't that enough without you beating him to death?
Come, Nancy. We must have civil words, Bill.
Civil words? Oh, yeah, you deserve them from me, because I was on the streets for you when I was a child, half his age, and I've been in the same trade and the same service for 15 years, and don't you forget it!
Well, if you have, it's your living, ain't it?
Oh. Some living!
What you deserve, you get.
No getting or giving!
Must we have murders yet?
There'll be murders, there'll be terrors, such as
Lord
you've never seen.
No violence, please, no violence.
Nancy, make no errors, there ain't no in between.
Lord,
no
violence. If you don't mind making a mate of Satan, it's a fine life.
Fine life.
My life, Satan.
Now we don't mind keeping the angels waiting. It's a fine life.
Fine life.
Fine life.
Come back and do as you want to.
Watch out.
Bill has got a heart of gold.
Get out on
better
the job.
Better not to mess with it. Better make the best of it. It's a fine
life.
Look after it, Bill. Dodger. Look after him. Look after him. And I'll look after myself. A man's got a heart, hasn't he? Joking apart, hasn't he? And though I'd be the first one to say that I wasn't a saint, I'm finding it hard to be really as black as a pint. I'm reviewing the situation. Can a fellow be a villain all his life? All the trials and tribulation, better settle down and get myself a wife. And a wife can cook and sew for me, and come for me, and go for me, and go for me, and nag at me, the fingers she would wag at me, the money she would take from me, a misery she'd make from me. Think I better think this out again. A wife you can keep anyway. I'd rather sleep anyway. Live without anyone in the world, and I'm starting from now. So how to win friends and to influence people? So how? I'm reviewing the situation. I must quickly look up everyone I know. Titled people with a station who can help me make a real impressive show. I will own a suite of carriages and run a fleet of carriages and wave at all the duchesses with friendliness as much as is befitting of my new estate. Good morrow to you, magistrate. I think I better think this out again. So where do I go? Somebody? Who do I know? Nobody. Oh, my dearest companions have always been villains and thieves. So in my time of life, I should start turning over new leaves. I'm reviewing the situation. If you're going to eat, you've got to earn a bob. Is it such a humiliation for a rapper to perform an honest job? So a job I'm getting, possibly, I wonder who the boss will be. I wonder if he'll take to me, what bonuses he'll make to me. I'll start at 8 and finish late at normal rate. And all but wait, think I better think this out again. What happens when I'm 70? Must come a time, 70, when you're old and it's cold, and who cares if you live or you die? Your one consolation's the money you may have put by. I'm reviewing the situation. I'm abandoned and abandoned I shall stay. You'll be seen, no transformation. But it's wrong to be a rogue in every way. I don't want nobody hurt for me. I'm made to do the dirt for me. This rotten life is not for me. It's gotten far too hot for me. Don't want no one to rob for me. But who will find a job for me? There is no in-between for me. But who will change the scene for me? I think I better think this out again. Hey!
Married. And 2 weeks ago, tomorrow, it was done. It seems like an age. I sold myself for 6 teaspoons, a pair of sugar tongs, a milk pot, a small quantity of second-hand furniture. I went very reasonable. I went cheap, dirt cheap.
Cheap? You would have been dear at half the price, and dear enough I paid for you. Lord above knows that. Are you going to sit there snoring all day?
I shall sit here as long as I think proper, ma'am. And although I was not snoring, I shall snore, burp, gasp, clap, or cry as the humor strikes me, such being my prerogative.
Your prerogative?
I said the word, ma'am. The prerogative of a man is to command.
And what is the prerogative of a woman in the name of goodness?
To obey. To obey. Your late unfortunate husband should have taught you that. If he had, he might be alive today. I wish he was. Poor man. There we go. Cry away, Mum. Cry away. It opens the lungs, exercises the eyes, softens the temper, and washes the face. So cry away.
No, talk about your prerogative if you dare.
I am going
Shut
to...
Shut up! And take yourself away from here, unless you want me to do something desperate. Well, are you going?
I have no intention of staying, Mum. It's just you're so very violent.
Oh, God. What's the matter?
It's old Sally, Mum. She's got something to tell you that must be heard. She's not got long, and she needs to talk to you before she dies.
Oh, you better come in. Yes, what is it? Turn her away.
Oh, Sally, it's your
Go
own
Go on, get out of it.
Piss off.
Now listen to me. In this very workhouse, I once nursed a pretty young creature who came to me from the cold with her feet all cut and bruised from walking. She gave birth to a boy and died. Let me see, what was the year again?
Never mind the year, what of him?
I robbed her! I robbed her, so I did. The only thing she had of any worth. It was round her neck and it was gold.
Gold?
This is it, the locket. She charged me to keep it safe and she trusted me. It's my belief she came from a rich family.
The boy's name?
They called him Olive.
We must retrieve that boy, Mr. Bumble.
We must indeed, Mum. We must indeed.
Oliver, Oliver.
That was the mite with the large appetite.
Oliver, Oliver. Apparently he's from a rich family.
And to think we nearly stupidly went and lost track of him.
If the truth were known, we'd both be delighted at seeing the back of him.
Oliver, Oliver.
What will we do?
We must give him his due.
And we'll rise the day. Somebody gave us raise the flag. Coming to save us cash rewards. Plus a promotion, who'd have thought? And a notion, praise the Lord. Somebody brought us Oliver.
I understand you've news of the boy, Oliver Twist.
We decided to come in answer to your advertisement.
I decided.
That's right, my dear wife decided. Bumble's the name, sir. Beadle of the workhouse where the boy was cared for. Where he was apprenticed to an undertaker who he ran away from.
Yes,
it was
yes, good of you to come. So what information do you have to tell me?
This locket was given by the lad's dying mother to my wife just before she passed away. The boy's mother, not my wife.
So, you say the boy left your workhouse and went to an undertaker?
Yes, Mr. Sowerberry, the undertaker. Took him for £3.
Oh, so you mean to say that you sold the boy like an animal?
Well, it was Mrs. Bumble who authorized the sale.
Really? Then I shall see to it that neither of you are employed in a position of trust again. Madam, your behavior is shameful. Leave my house.
How dare you speak to me so, sir? I came here to help you.
You came here in an attempt to profit from your own greed and dishonesty.
Sir, if you think that trocket don't belong to my wife...
Shut up, you old fool.
Yes, yes. Here's £10. Take it. And consider yourselves fortunate that you don't find yourselves in the hands of the law. Mrs. Bedwin, show these ghastly people out.
Yes, sir.
We know the way out. Thank you very much.
I hope, sir, that this unfortunate little circumstance will not affect my parochial office.
Oh, indeed it will. And you should think yourself well off besides.
It was Mrs. Bumble. She would do it.
That's no excuse. You were present on the occasion of the sale of the boy, and indeed are the more guilty of the two in the eyes of the law. For the law supposes that your wife acts at your direction.
If the law supposes that, then the law's an ass. If that's the eye of the law, then the law is a bachelor. And the most that I can hope for the law is that its eyes are opened by experience. By experience!
There's a young woman inquiring for you, sir.
Mrs. Bedwin, have a look at this miniature. Can you see who it is?
Why, it's Miss Agnes, sir.
Yes, my daughter, Agnes. She must have found her way to that workhouse and had the child there.
If only she had told us.
Mrs. Bedwin, who is this?
It's about the boy, sir.
You've news of Oliver.
He's in danger, in bad company. He was dragged off the day you sent him out with them books.
Who took him?
Me. And someone else.
Where can I find him? Who is this other person you speak of? Take me to him.
No, we can't. I shouldn't have said that.
Please, please. Come, sit down. You want to help the boy, don't you? Why else would you have come?
I do want to help, but I...
Then take me to him.
I can't, but I'll bring him to you.
Where?
Not here. It's too far.
Where?
The bridge. London Bridge, tonight at midnight. And you gotta come alone. Promise me you'll come on your own, and I'll find a way of getting him to you. You don't believe me, do you? But if you want Oliver back, then you've gotta believe me.
Very well. I'll be there.
Thank God.
Wait! Has the boy been hurt? ill-treated in any way? If so...
But please, please, he'll kill me if he finds out where I've been.
Who is this man? Perhaps we
no,
can...
No, no, we can't. Whatever else I do, I won't turn on him.
I understand, my dear.
But this man who might kill you?
But he's mine, and I'm his. I've got to go back. I want to go back.
Do you think we can trust her, Mr. Brownlow?
Mrs. Bedwin, I'm afraid we have no choice.
He doesn't act as though he cares, but deep inside I know he cares, and that is why I'm tied right by. Life is long. I'll love him, right or wrong, but something just as strong says someone else needs me. A child with no one to take his part. I'll take his part, Bill, but cross my heart, I won't betray your trust. No, people say I must. My heart will stay true and just as long. Here, and I'll go look for Mr. Brownlow. There's a good boy. Stay.
Nancy!
Bill! Don't take him back there, Bill! Let him go, for pity's sake. Let him go. Why you look that way at me, Bill?
Give me away, will you?
No, you, Bill, never you.
Get away from me, woman.
Look at me. I've been true to you for my soul.
Get away from me!
God help me!
Stop staring at me, woman. Close your damn eyes! Your eyes! Damn you! Thank you.
I say, you there! Stop! Stop!
Oh, my God. Help! Help!
What happened here?
There's been a murder.
Do you know this woman?
I came here to meet this poor creature. When I crossed the bridge, someone was running in that direction.
It's Nancy! Somebody's murdered Nancy!
What did he look like?
He was a broad-shouldered, heavily built man.
What else?
He wore a black coat and carried a heavy cudgel.
Bill Sykes!
What's going on?
It's Nancy! Bill Sykes has killed Nancy!
Where will we find him?
The Bear Fagans!
Fagin!
Bill, what is it?
Let me in, Fagin.
What have you done, Bill? No, not Nancy, it can't be.
The game's up, Fagin. Let me in, then.
I can't let you in. It's not safe here.
Well, what will I do, then?
Head for Limehouse. It's your best bet. Boys, come on. Out, out.
Fagin!
What?
What do I do?
Live up your name, dodge about.
Me up!
First thing!
I don't know. Battery! That one it is! Wake it up or I smack them all, gentlemen, in the early hours of the morning! Shame on you!
Or I'll kill the boy! Get the rope. The rope! Your eyes, Nancy. Your eyes!
Of course not, dear boy. I could never be that. Come, Oliver. We'll take you home now.
Can somebody change? It's possible. It may be strange, but it's possible. All my dearest companions and treasures I've left behind. I'll turn a leaf over, and who can say what I may find?
exactly what you want to wear.